Welcome to the VEX Robotics Competition Referee Training Videos, designed for both referees and teams. This is Chapter 11, VEX U. VEX U is the university-level version of the VEX Robotics Competition. It is intended to provide a unique competition opportunity for university students. VEX U teams play the same game and use the same field layout as VRC teams. But there are a few twists that keep the competition fresh and enable students to explore collegiate-level manufacturing and programming challenges. In this video, we're not going to look at every difference, just a few of the major ones that will impact referees the most. Specifically, two robot teams, the autonomous period, and the different robot materials that are now allowed in VEX U. First, two robots. VRC teams build one robot that fits within an 18-inch cube and are randomly allied with partners to create two team alliances of 18-inch robots. In VEX U, teams build two robots, thus essentially creating their own two-robot alliance. One of these robots must start within a 24-inch cube, and the other must start in a 15-inch cube. This has a few implications for referees. The most obvious is how it changes robot expansion limits. This is detailed by Rule VUG6. The VRC Rule SG2 applies in VEX U, adjusted for the starting height of each robot. A. The robot which starts 24 inches tall must return to 24 inches once it is no longer contacting the expansion zone. The robot which starts 15 inches tall must return to 15 inches once it is no longer contacting the expansion zone. B. The 36-inch horizontal expansion limit applies to both robots. So, the same guidelines explained in Chapter 9 still apply here. It's just that the vertical heights have changed. But don't worry, there are still some visual cues that can be used to get a rough estimate of the robot height limits. For the 24-inch robot, the bottom edge of the middle flags sits at about 26 inches above the foam field tiles, and the shorter posts extend about 23 inches up from the foam field tiles. So, if the robot can reach the middle row of flags, or is extending more than an inch beyond the posts, you know it's too tall. For the 15-inch robot, the best reference is technically to the exact center line of the low flag. However, because this can be a bit more difficult to gauge, event partners are encouraged to add pieces of white tape at 15 inches on the posts to help referees. Note that for the 36-inch horizontal limit, this pretty severely restricts the horizontal expansion of a 24-inch robot, since its diagonal is already almost 36 inches. However, the 15-inch robot can actually expand to over twice its original size. Again, teams will need to keep this in mind when designing their robots. The changes to robot size rules also apply in the Robot Skills Challenge. There is one other major restriction in the VEX U Robot Skills Challenge. Teams must use the 15-inch robot. The other major implication of VEX U's robot rules is VUG1A. Teams are allowed to build as many robots as they would like, but only two, one of each size, may be brought from the pit to the playing field for any match. Referees who are used to VRC are familiar with R1 and R2, which prohibit teams from bringing multiple robots to a competition. However, in VEX U, having different robots for different situations is allowed and encouraged. This especially will become prevalent in the Robot Skills Challenge. The next major change to gameplay that referees should be aware of is the increased emphasis on autonomous programming. In VEX U, the autonomous period at the beginning of every match lasts for 45 seconds, and the driver control period is shortened to 75 seconds. This is intended to encourage collegiate teams to develop advanced autonomous routines. However, if both teams complete their routines before 45 seconds has passed, they may signal to the referee that they wish to end early and go straight to driver control. This is usually done with a crossed arms symbol and a verbal confirmation. And finally, the most significant difference between VEX U teams and their VRC counterparts, VUR2 and VUR3. VUR2 states the following: teams may use any official VEX Robotics product other than the exceptions noted below to construct their robot. The most common implication of this rule will be the inclusion of VEX Pro components into VEX U robots. The VEX Pro product line includes a vast array of wheels, gearboxes, and hardware that VEX U teams may find interesting. The VersaFrame system will be especially useful for teams who wish to use the new array of aluminum stock and gussets for robot construction. So, referees and inspectors may need to familiarize themselves with this product line before arriving at competition. This is an example of a perfectly legal VEX U drivetrain built entirely out of VEX Pro components and V5 motors. As if that wasn't enough, VUR3 is where the robots will really start to look different. VUR3 states the following. Teams are allowed to fabricate their own unique components from the following additional raw materials for each of their robots. A. An unlimited amount of non-shattering plastic. B. An unlimited amount of composite materials. C. An unlimited number of plastic 3D printed parts. D. An unlimited amount of steel and aluminum. The intent of VUR3 is to encourage teams to explore advanced fabrication techniques like milling or 3D printing. In order to permit this, we had to make these raw materials legal. However, the intent is not to legalize commercially available items that are made from these materials. The difference is a bit subtle on paper, but should become clear in practice. Did you machine this bracket yourself out of aluminum bar stock? Or did you purchase it as a bracket from an online store? Did you design this plastic wheel in CAD and then 3D print it? Or did you purchase it from an RC car shop? Referees and inspectors will need to be diligent and be willing to ask these types of questions if you see something that looks unfamiliar. Similarly, teams who wish to utilize custom components should be prepared to answer these questions or provide supporting documentation when asked. We look forward to seeing how VEX U teams will take advantage of these new opportunities to push competitive VEX robots to another level. That's all for Chapter 11, but make sure you check out the other chapters that explore other refereeing topics.